Hi, I'm Katie Quinn, the Communications Manager for the City of Rock Hill. Today I have with me Mayor John Geddes, and we're going to talk about the idea of a livable wage. Okay. We had a livable wage summit last week.
That's right, last Thursday.
And so can you tell me where the idea for a living wage or a livable wage came from?
Here in Rock Hill?
Yeah.
Well, it's something last year when campaigning for the office of mayor, it's something that I promised people we'd have a conversation about. That as a community, you know, we have a lot of pushes and pulls that we have, but I think it's important that we know as people what people ought to make in our community in order to be able to pay the necessities. And so in going through that campaign we had it scheduled for mid-September and the hurricane came through and we pushed it, but just real adamant that we need to have this conversation.
And so tell me a little bit about what the livable wage was and what the result was of that summit.
Sure. Well, at the summit we had Mike Sheely, and Mike works for the state of South Carolina. He's the Senate Finance Committee person that works on the state budget. So that's all he does all day, every day. And the state of South Carolina is, as most everybody realizes, a huge proportion of the budget's preordained every year, so to speak, in that it's Medicaid and education. And after you get through those two things, there's really not much money, relatively speaking, to divide up and send around. And I just thought it would be intriguing to hear from the person who's solely responsible for making everything meet up and balance out, to come up and share with us as a community why he believes we should be paying a living wage. Not why Rock Hill should be paying a living wage, but why all employers in South Carolina should be paying a living wage. And so Mike went through his analysis and his slideshow. It was fascinating. It's on the website if anybody wants to go look at it. And then following him, we had Dr. Laura Ulrich, who's from Winthrop University. And she had done a study based on an MIT study that they do for every county, but she brought it home to Rock Hill. And she talked about things like poverty wages and living wage and minimum wage and made the distinction between the three, which I can't make. I couldn't quite grasp all that. But after doing that, she established, you know, what a livable wage would be for families that had, say, one worker in the workforce and two children, or two workers in the workforce with two children, and gave several scenarios of how that would look.
And so the amount that we landed on is $14.50 per hour is what the living wage is or should be in Rock Hill.
Right. When you look at certain family makeups, that's true. If it's two working people in one household with two children, it would be $14.50 an hour. If it were one working adult with two children, it would be roughly twice that, $29 and some change an hour. And so that's what the analysis, looking at all the factors, looking at the cost of housing, the cost of medical care, the cost of transportation, things of that nature, that's what she landed on for two working adults in a four-person household was $14.50 an hour, which, you know, is a lot more than minimum wage, and is a little bit more, I believe, or is more than a poverty wage as she defined it. But again, you got me on that one.
And the city has committed to start paying that amount before the end of this calendar year.
That's correct. When we started going through and working through what this conference would look like or what this presentation would look like, before we got Mike Sheely's report and Dr. Laura Ulrich's report, in talking with city management, the city management felt like with council support, we could get there by the year 2020. But after seeing these reports that came in, after seeing the high cost of housing in Rock Hill versus Charlotte, after seeing all these other things, and then also recognizing all the growth that's coming to Rock Hill and the new bus system. So transportation will be at least better than it's ever been before with this free bus system. And when looking at these jobs that are coming in, when we have record low unemployment, and when we have the federal government easing up on all the regulations that they have, and the stimulus bill when they redid the taxes, that if it's not now, when are we going to do this? And that's really what it sort of shook out to be after all of that work. And I'm proud of our city management team and our city council to take the position that we can't wait to 2020, that everything's lined up just right for this. And so the city was willing to step forward and say by December 1st of 2018, so 40 days from now, less than that now, the city will be paying a living wage. And I'm proud, I'm very proud of the city management for making that happen.
You had mentioned that it came out in the presentation that there is the housing costs in Rock Hill are actually higher than what they are in Charlotte. And I know there's been a lot of discussion about affordable housing. And what do you see as next steps for Rock Hill to move forward and making sure that there's a sufficient supply of affordable housing?
You know, to me, that's the biggest task we have before us. It's something that I think about all the time. It's something that certain members of city management that are charged with that are working hard on, because not only do we have to recognize that affordable housing is a problem in Rock Hill, we also have to recognize that, you know, that's the easy part. How do you solve that? You know, how do you identify new ways of looking at that? How do you support older ways that we've done it and been successful so it's on a grander scale? So, you know, when you look at the last year or so at the city of Rock Hill and you see, you know, an indoor sports and event center opening next April, when you see a new transportation system, again, I'll say it, a free electric bus system running four routes in downtown Rock Hill, you know, those are all elements on how we make this community a significant community. And when you look at record unemployment, when you look at employers having the opportunity now to consider paying a livable wage, and if that means a position or two aren't filled that would have been filled in the past, it's okay. There are other jobs out there. Mm-hmm. And so if you're ever going to try to make this jump, if you ever felt a sense of urgency for how you drive your community to be significant, we're in the perfect time. I mean, we just have such an opportunity. And affordable housing, I think, is the next thing that we've got to start to tackle and really get aggressive about.
Okay, well, sounds like it was a very successful summit, and look forward to seeing what other businesses in our community can do to support that initiative and start paying living wage. And if you want some more information about living wage, visit cityofrockhill.com and look for the presentation materials. And also WRHI live streamed and has the audio from the summit on their website. So make sure that you listen to what Mike Sheely and Dr. Ulrich had to say and get some more information. Thank you, Mayor.
Yeah, thank you. And just to recognize, this isn't the end of it. Yes. This is the beginning of that conversation. So we're looking forward to working with everyone. And I should say, just to be very clear, the city's not mandating a livable wage or is not mandating a rise in the minimum wage or anything like that. This is just what the city's chosen to do. And then now I hope that what we'll start to look is how can we develop opportunities for our employers in the community that aren't already paying livable wages, because there are some that are, but those that aren't paying livable wages now, how do we help incentivize, how do we help get them to a point where they can?
All right. Sounds like we've got a lot of work cut out for
us.
Yes,
ma'am. Always on.
That's right. The conversation has started. So thank you very much, Mayor.
Thank you, Katie.